Hello, hello, I'm Li Hao. Today we're going to talk about if logic block. We have seen how we can use dynamic data to present onto the templates in your Svelte component, but we haven't talked about how we can, based on a certain condition, show or hide a certain content. So this is what we're going to do today. So over here, I have prepared some examples for you, as always. So here I have two buttons. One called condition. The second button is also called condition, right? But they are controlling different conditions. So let me name it better. So this is condition one and this is condition two. So as I click on each of the buttons, I add event listener so that it will toggle that condition. So if it's initially true, then it will turn to false. If it's initially false, it will turn it to true, right? So as I click, you'll see that it turns from true to false, false to true. So now with all this set up, we're going to see how we can, based on this condition, to show some content. So firstly, first is that to write this if block, we use we start with a curly brackets and then a hash and an if. So this is how we start the if block, and then we type in the condition. So this, we are going to use the condition one. And with that, to close it, we use curly brackets again and then backslash if. So in between, we can pass in any content, right? So I'm going to say any condition one is true. So if the condition, if I turn toggle on, toggle off the condition one, you'll see that this will be hidden. But when I turn condition one to true, this will be shown. So anything within this block of if condition will be shown based on the condition itself. So the condition is any expressions. You can pass in any expressions. So I can say, condition one and condition two. So this time round, if I turn on any of it, it will be hidden. But if I turn on both, then it will be shown. Right. So this will be based on both the condition, condition one and two. So anything here can be a expressions, right? And so again, so to recall, we start with a hash if, and then we end with a slash if. So this marks the beginning and the end. And as what we would do in JavaScript, we have if, we sometimes like to have else, right? If certain things do this, else do something else. So same thing goes with the logic block as well. We can have an else condition. So if show something, else show something else. So over here, we can type else. But this time around, when we say else, we are going to start with a colon sign. So curly brackets again, and then colon else, and then close your curly brackets. So else, I will say either condition one or two is false. So as you can see, if I turn on, it will say either one of the condition is false. If I both is true, then it will show the first content. Okay, so now I'm going to tell you there's actually a pattern. There's a pattern in logic blocks. So you learn this pattern now. It applies to other logic blocks that we are going to talk about in future. The pattern is this. When you want to start something, you start with a hash sign. So curly brackets, hash sign and something, right? In this case, we are learning about if, then it will start with a hash if. To end that, we will have to use a slash if, right? So this marks the beginning and this marks the end. And anything in between, anything in between, use a colon sign. So in this case, we have colon else. We can have colon else if as well, right? In JavaScript, you have if, else, and then you end, right? You can have if, else if, another condition, else if, another condition, and else, and end, or without else, as you can see, right? You can have as many else if or else in between. So the same thing goes with Svelte logic blocks. You can have else if, so anything in between of the if, you use a colon, right? So else if, and then you can type anything you like. So in this case, I want to say condition 1 or condition 2. So again, this is whatever you type over here can be any JavaScript expressions. It could be condition 1 or condition 2. It could be a function call, right? Maybe I'm going to say check condition 1, 2. And I'm going to define this function on the top. So I'm going to say check condition 1. Whoops. Condition 2. And return. Right, this works as well. We can we can pull this function, extract this into a function and call a function over here. Right, and then probably over here I put some content. So you can see immediately if I don't put anything, Svelte actually will complain. It's like, you have nothing over here, right? Which means there's room to improve in this code itself. We probably don't have to check this condition to put an empty. Maybe we can have else an alternate condition and then put like over here instead, right? We can compact this instead of leaving like one condition that has empty block. So over here, I'm going to say condition 1 or 2 is true. Right. So now if I turn, you will see that it will change the wording. And if both of them are false, then either is false, right? I think now it should say both condition 1 and 2 is false, right? So you can play with this however you want, right? So logic blocks. So logic blocks itself, like any other elements in Svelte, they can nest itself as well. So I can come over here and I can nest again. So say, for example, I have condition 3. Right? And I can come over here and nest it at anywhere I like. I can nest it over here, say if condition 3. Another content. Right? So if you can see over here. And I can put it over here as well if I want. I can have as many, within a block, I can have as many number of elements I want. So I can have one div, or in fact, I can have two divs if I want to, any content I like, right? I can nest conditions and I can keep nesting them. And no one say I can't do that. Right? So the sky is the limit. You can do as however you want. The sky is the limit. You can just treat a logic block itself like an element which can have children, and so you can nest, have like logic blocks and then element and then maybe logic blocks again and then element and then and all the way down to nowhere, right? So there you go. Here you have if logic blocks for you to show or hide content based on the condition, right? Based on certain logics. Which is if the condition is true, then you will show something. If it's false, you'll hide it. And we've seen how we can start and end a block. And we see the pattern over here where to start a block, you use you use curly brackets and then a hash sign. And to end it, you use the same name, right? So if you start with a curly, you used to start with if, then you have to end with an if block. And this time around, when you end, you use a slash. And anything in between, say else if, else, you start with a curly brackets and then a colon sign. So if you have any questions, feel free to comment down below and ask me any questions you have. And if you like this video, give me a thumbs up. And as always, subscribe to my channel so that you get notified when the next one is out. So see ya, bye bye.